Christopher Columbus arrived in Cuba in 1492, marking the start of a colonization that would decimate the indigenous population. Independence would not be regained until the turn of the 20th century.
Cuba, of course, was a Spanish colony originally, and it was one of the very last Spanish colonies to gain its independence. Most of Latin America became independent early in the 19th century. Cuba didn't become independent until 1898, and it was because of U.S. intervention in the Spanish-American War. And that led to a dependency on the United States that lasted for the next half century.
This is Stuart Norman speaking from the business section of downtown Havana. Just 28 days ago, a revolution threw out one government and brought in a new government.
Dictatorial rule continued in Cuba until Fidel Castro's Cuban Revolution brought it to an end in 1959. Alarmed by Castro's friendly relations with the Soviets, the U.S. repeatedly supported attempts to remove him from power.
Fidel Castro came to power in 1959 at the head of a revolution to unseat Fulgencio Batista, who was supported by the United States. Castro aligned Cuba with the Soviet Union at a time of great tension during the Cold War. You had the Cuban Missile Crisis, you had the invasion in Guantanamo Bay, the Bay of Pigs, which was a tremendous failure during the Kennedy administration. So this only hardened the opposition on both sides.
Fidel Castro was able to really mobilize that sense of nationalism and anti-Americanism in his revolution in 1959. Relations with the United States deteriorated right away. The Bay of Pigs, 1961, where we sent an exile force to try to overthrow him. The missile crisis in 1962, where he accepted Soviet nuclear weapons. Those were the really striking high points of the conflict between Cuba and the United States.
The U.S. imposed a trade embargo on Cuba in 1960 and broke off diplomatic relations with Havana.
The embargo was imposed by the Eisenhower government because it was irritated with the Cuban Revolution and with its leader, Fidel Castro, who was no friend of the United States and wanted to do his own thing without interference.
Cuba got great value in aligning itself with the Soviet Union, material resources and trade and benefits, and a great security ally against the enemy, the United States. And that's what we saw. That was Fidel's mantra for 40, 50 years, until 2006, when his brother took office.